Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand. Back again. Another question here. I have low IgA. What should I do? So there are different antibodies that your body makes. In fact, I think there are five. IgE, IgA, IgG, IgM, and I'm getting old. My memory's gone. I'm pretty sure there were five. So IgA is probably the most abundant antibody that your immune system makes. I have done some previous videos on secretory IgA. So it's made, I think, around about 5, 6, or 7 thousand milligrams is made per day. So quite a large amount is secreted in the lumen, so in the area of the small intestine in particular. So this antibody is very important because it acts a little bit like those TSA guys when you go to LAX. I just had an interesting experience at LAX. I should tell you about this. Recently on a trip when I went to America with Tracy, we went there and I was a little bit tired. I think I was allowed to be tired after a 12-hour plane trip. And I sat there, walked up, you know, you got queues of people. I got to a counter and I leaned up on the counter and the lady said, "Stand back, sir, stand back." Man, I got barked at like I was in boot camp or something, you know. These big handguns strapped all around the waist and that. I thought I was going to get a pistol whip or something like that. So, but yeah, that was my experience of LAX. I can tell you guys, you don't get that experience when you go to Auckland Airport in New Zealand. They don't look at you like you're Saddam Hussein or something like that. But I got pretty frightened. Anyway, where was I? I was talking about secretory IgA. So the Border Patrol people do a really good job. I can't knock them. I've had great experiences in America with nearly everybody I've met. I find American people fantastic people, in fact. But I just get a bit spooked at airports at times. They're doing their job. I mean, come on, they've got to protect the country. Antibodies have to protect the body. They're doing their job. Sometimes numbers are low, sometimes numbers are high, you know. And the crazy thing is, when we came back from Las Vegas flying out to LAX to go back to Auckland, there were these TSA people everywhere. But what we hadn't have known is that the shooting in Vegas had just happened. So they were on red alert, just like antibodies are on red alert. So if a pathogen is seen in the gut, all of a sudden all these TSA antibodies are going to hang around. So very high amounts of secretory IgA will alert you that there's something not really right in the gut. Something is upsetting the digestive system, and antibodies are made and secreted and pushed in large amounts to particular areas where they can upregulate inflammation. This can create sore spots sometimes, or tender points for people in the gut, I found. I have found many stool test results with people with high antibodies to have a little bit of a tender abdominal region. So, but what do we do when we have a low IgA? How do we boost the numbers up? How do we get our gut's TSA up to a nice high count again? Well, we can't go online and recruit them. You know, we can't put advertisements in newspapers. We've got to boost them up. So this is where I talk about my 4R method. I wrote about this in my book, and you can read about it in Candida Crusher on page 113 and 114. I wrote about this. So if you've got my book, go to those pages now and read about the replace, the remove, the replace, the repair, the inoculate, and the repair. So that's what we're going to talk about now, the 4R method on boosting IgA. Obviously, you've got to remove, so you've got to take the bad guy out. So it's important for you to, if you are unwell for some time, is to do some type of test, find out, you know, what the heck is lurking inside here. You know, that way you know exactly what type of gun to point at it. If you have got a bad guy in there, are we going to use a bazooka or a handgun or a hand grenade? What are we going to use on this guy to get rid of him? So, you know, not wanting to beat my own drum, I created Candida Remove for this purpose. So Candida Remove does exactly what number one is, remove. It removes the bad guy. Right? It targets many different types of candida. It targets many different types of dysbiotic flora, the bad bacteria. And it targets parasites. So, you know, we could look at it as like pedophiles, terrorists, and anyone from, I don't know, I'm not going to mention a country, I was going to say North Korea, but I won't say that. So it targets, you know, different array of bad people or bad guys in the gut, and it's going to do that efficiently. When you're taking a product to eradicate or remove, always consider a broad spectrum product. You don't need to take 6 or 7 different supplements like, you know, caprylic acid, oregano, grapefruit seed extract, this. It's expensive, cumbersome, and generally not necessary. You're better off taking one product that does the cleanup. So first, identify your target. Second is hone in for, you know, I don't like using the kill word, but I'll say the kill word here, is to eradicate, clean up, all right? The second thing you want to do is replace. So you want to really tidy up the area and improve the enzymes in the body in particular. Enzymes are very important to replace because many people who've got a gut problem have got a deficiency with enzymes. They're not functioning properly. So again, this is when I created Canzino Restore, which is a probiotic enzyme formula. It works particularly well with Remove. So Remove and Restore work really as a pigeon pair. But putting enzymes into the body, we're going to really allow the digestion to occur more efficiently. We're going to break food down to a higher efficiency. We're going to, you know, hopefully, you know, get on top of the bloating and the gas and all the uncomfortable sensations people have got. Better digestion improves uptake, improves energy and well-being. It also facilitates better bowel motions because you're going to get better fermentation lower down in the gut. So we've done the Remove. We're replacing enzymes. The third one is we're re-inoculating. Now we want to put good bugs into the area because lactobacillus in particular, when you get good counts, has been associated with boosting secretory IgA. In most cases of a stool test, when I find very low IgA, I immediately flip to the front page to look where the beneficials are. And quite oftentimes we'll find low lactobacillus, sometimes nil growth. There's nothing there we can culture. And then we look at the IgA, oops, well, we've got a level of 12 or 14. So you want an IgA level of around 100 to 150. Some people have got it at 2,000. They've got way too many TSI guys running around pointing guns at everybody. And some people have got nothing. They're down to, you know, 1.2. They've got one TSA girl or guy in the whole airport with all these crazy people running around. You can't have that. So you don't want too many people with guns. And you don't want nobody with guns. You at least want one guy with a gun there, preferably more than one. So the re-inoculation part is very important, because what we're trying to do now is really boost up that nice beneficial count of the lactobacillus higher up in the gut, the bifidobacteria lower down. It comes on the back end of using enzymes, okay? And it also comes on the back end of using the Remove. So it's a very clever system. Remove, replace, re-inoculate, and then we're going to do the repair. We're going to give you Canzino Rebuild, which repairs. You keep taking the Canzino Restore, which keeps seeding the gut with good bugs. It's also got the enzymes which facilitate the breakdown of the new improved diet you're on. Now we've got Rebuild. The Rebuild is a multi with a nice back end of an antimicrobial back end. At this point, you can reduce the Canzino Remove and keep taking Rebuild. Rebuild, many of my patients take for 1-2 years and just ongoing, they take one or two per day. I know they're a bit on the big and bulky side. You can crush them up, but they work fantastic. So that's the Remove, Replace, Re-inoculate, Repair mechanism for boosting IgA. It's on page 114 of Candida Crusher. Thanks for tuning in.